Welcome back to Hammer and the Blow on the workbench number 6. Redesigned the head, went back into the Fusion 360 there, and ran up the holes through the base of the head, up the holes through the rear of the head. I could have put them center, but I choose this way for no reason whatsoever. So if I spin it round, you'll see the back end of it as well. I put a little bracketry on the back end of it so it can fit up the pole. I bring a pole in, there we have it. Head fits on the pole like so. I put the face on as well. You see a bit better. So that's the traveling head there. A bit more prototypical, I think, than sitting on top of the pole itself. Take away all the head and the face on through the pole. You can see the pole there as well. It's got a little hole through it. And also the basic pole as well has got the little ring to put onto the layout as well. I'll print them out. Usually use a 3mm carbon fibre rod rather than a print. Don't know how strong it'll be, but time will tell, I think. So I'll take you over to see the prints and you can see how well they turned out or didn't turn out in some cases. Well, there we have it. It's been printed off. That's my first attempt here. On the poles there, three did fail, not have support on top of it, and two came out. Quite strange, as it's the same supports on each pole. And over here is the heads on the side of it. That's, one's came off already quite easily, snapped it out. You see the little bracketry on the back end for fitting top of the pole, and also I've got the holes through the back end as well. So I did redesign this one here, and this is the result of that one. Didn't quite clean it good enough, bit of resin on the bottom end of it, so I'll need to check the holes and see how they go. I only need one pole, perfect. The rest may go to the members of the Merck meeting. Also a bit of space on the model, so I put in some of these bollards. I did do six of these bollards as well for the layout. You've got to do a print, may as well do a print. It doesn't cost you any more time wise, it's done by height. So you fill the base plate, you may as well fill it up and use it. So I'll take them off the sprue, put them in paint, and then we'll see how easy it is to attach the diodes this time. Well, I've got a bit of Scottish sunshine there, and I've painted up the back units, so made up the LEDs as well. Very, very hard to see them, folks. I do apologise. Quite a difficult thing to try and film this one, so we'll try the green one first, stick it in, glue it in. I've got them all glued in and soldered. We'll try and that's not quite nice, quite nice. Took some super glue out. I'm going to use the TP80. No expense spared today. We'll get an RTP-80 out to poke it in. A bit of activator as well. We'll now go into the orange. Try and bend the wires at a 90 degree angle. And you'll put the spray glue onto the mat. Last but not least, the red. Yeah, I must admit, that's a lot easier that way. Enjoys working with super glue. It's a matter of tying the gobbins together. So I just need to get the pole and put all the wires down it. But before I do that, I'll give a little test. Red. Green. Orange. Or amber, as I keep getting corrected. I'll come to the pole and see what it looks like. I do apologise for the shadows today, folks. It's an unusual day in Scotland. The sun's out. The background's alive, drying the hair, true fashions. Yeah, I've got a bit of glue on top of that and see what it's like. TP60. So I'll put the face on top of it. I just painted that now. Put that on top of it and then glue it up as well and give me a comparison. Never have them, folks, there. That's one with the head on top of a pole. And this is the new one. I think it looks pretty nice. Yeah. Hope you liked it, folks. Leave a comment what one you prefer. If you prefer the head on top of the pole or the head on the side of the pole. Let me know what you think. And I'll catch you again some other time. Cheers. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.